All right, so too often we're left wanting more when it comes to our favorite TV shows. So we wanted to go down that road and do our top three TV shows if they were to return for just one more season with the same cast. Now, we got deep into this because I was like, what if a lead character is dead, right? So for me, you know, that really threw off The Sopranos off my list because no Tony Soprano to me. The show's going to be garbage, so that's not going to be on my list. But there were some other factors I took into place when doing this.
Did you factor in the real-life cast of the show as well?
Yeah.
Okay.
And where they are now, I think that plays a part in it, yeah.
Okay. So we'll have probably similar takes on this of where we imagine the show would be after we bring it back. Okay. But I'll let you start with number three.
All right, so for two of mine, they're from pure bitterness that the show got canceled, okay? And the first one, you guys will never hear of, and I've probably brought it up on the show and I shouldn't have, but the show is called Counterpart and it was on Stars. It was canceled after two seasons. It was a damned travesty. I'm still mad about it, and I still claim to the fact that it was too intelligent for television and nobody liked it because of that. I loved it, and I loved the rides it took me on in an academic sense to challenge me.
When we first started the show, you mentioned that to me, that I should get started on it.
I still think everyone should watch the two seasons that it has. It was great TV.
I watched the first four or five episodes, and it is very mind-numbing because you have to think all the way through it, and that's probably the reason why you like it.
Yeah, my wife...
You can't casually watch the show.
No. My wife would be over with it because she's on Facebook during every show.
Right.
She'd be lost. Like, you have to give it your full attention like people devote to movies. I don't think there's anything wrong with us devoting that to television, and this was a good... And Everybody's Alive, I'm pretty sure, that's still on the show because it was just canceled. So that's my number three.
That's a good one. Again, I haven't finished season one yet, but I would agree it's very... highbrow television.
Yeah.
My number three isn't necessarily highbrow, but that's Seinfeld. So Seinfeld obviously had a finale. Love it or hate it, it was kind of like a polar opposite. A lot of people were, you know, enthusiastic about it. Everybody, I don't know, had a feeling about it. It didn't leave anybody in the meh stage.
No.
You were high or low on it. That's the reason why I want to bring it back, though. I want to put Where Are They Now to it. So where's Kramer now? Where's Seinfeld? Where's George? That's the biggest question is, where's George? So take it back, you know, 20 years after the finale, what happens?
One more season.
We'll see, one more.
Yeah, I like that. I like that.
And everybody, is in a good place in their career to also do it.
Yeah.
I mean, I haven't heard from Kramer since, obviously, the bad stand-up.
That would be interesting to see if they all still live there, you know, what's going on in their lives. You could do a whole season out of it. Good one. Good one. We did just lose Jerry Stiller, though.
Yeah, unfortunately, George's
dad won't be back. We'll work that into the plot.
Yeah. My number three is another one that has a famous character you can't bring back, but that's Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. So, of course, you can't have Uncle Phil. But the reason why Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, I want to make this a very, very important here statement. You have to put Will and his kid in a place to come back to society. Because so far, Will Smith, all the movies he's been doing, the TV and the YouTube, it's hit a stage for most people. Will Smith hasn't risen in the consciousness of people for so long. This is his reunion, his comeback tour, and to put Jaden there at the same time as now the central piece of The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air makes sense to me.
Yeah, I liked the path you were going on. I think that... I think you were trying to help Will Smith. You're trying to revive his career a little bit, and this could do it. I say ditch your kid. Don't get Jaden in there.
He's going to focus on Will.
Yeah, you can still... He needs to have a kid in the show. I think that would be good. Just cast somebody else. But I like that, Jones.
Of course, you got Jazzy Jeff, and you got Carlton.
Like yeah.
No.
There's a lot that could be happening there. Maybe it's set back in Philly.
Yeah.
Ooh, that'd be good. That'd be good. I like where you're going there. I'm going to go down a similar path for my number two. Yeah, and I'm going to do one more season of Saved by the Bell.
Oh, good Lord.
That's right. You know.
There's too many to begin with.
The original cast, not, you know.
The college
not,
years.
Whoever the other people are. Not, you know, who was in there? Mike Golick or whatever from the college years? Or Bob Golick? Which one was it?
I don't know.
One of the Golicks. I don't know. But, I want to know what's going on with their lives now. In fact, I'm making this this show a dramedy, so it's going to be a lot of serious things. And how do they develop? Like, you know, Jesse kind of had a pill addiction to caffeine pills.
Yeah.
Let's get her, like, addicted to something, right? Lisa, she spent too much money. She's been through, like, three husbands. We could do that. It could be
Screech
great.
Has made porn.
Screech. Well, in his real life, you know. Yeah. But I would say maybe Screech is, like, the most successful one because he was the smartest. So
plot
kind
twist.
Of plot twist, role mm-hmm. reversal. I do have a question, and I was too lazy to look it up. Did the guy that played Belding, is he dead?
I think so, right?
I thought he was. I think he is too, so. For some reason.
Yeah,
so.
I think so.
But that's okay. We're focusing on the kids on this one. So, that's,
so are they teachers back in the school? Is that what kind of relates? It ties it back to the school?
No.
Are they the parents of the kids?
No. It's just them as adults.
Just in their regular adult life.
Yeah. Oh, okay. And you could do Saved by the Bell as like something happens to bring them all together for the last season.
Okay.
You know, maybe Belding's death.
I'm going to wholeheartedly agree or disagree with that decision on Saved by the Bell. I think it served way too many seasons.
Come
anyways.
On, people, support me. My number one, it goes back to the same as number three for me, and that's the Chappelle Show.
Mm.
Right?
There you go.
We only had two seasons of Dave Chappelle's brilliance. And his genius
with just Chappelle. They tried to create something else on the side. It just didn't work.
No.
But yeah,
we got to bring it back. Make a stand for something. This is a good time to bring it back. So you know, I still enjoyed the most recent comic stand up that he did on Netflix.
Mm-hmm.
Love Chappelle. Like, bring it back, and that's the one I think that needs at least one more season of fun.
Do you think it'd be more well-received or less well-received now that all this has happened in 2020?
I think he has a lot to work with.
Because, I mean, he pushed things
he
in
did.
The early 2000s.
But that's his genius. I'd like to see his spin on things
right.
and what he makes of everything that's happened in this year and how he would portray that in skit comedy. That's why you just give him the reins and let him go.
Man, that would be awesome. I don't know how much money it would take to do that, because they had to pay him, what, $20 million to do an hour stand-up? Imagine a whole season of that.
He loves his money.
So all the TV executives watching this show, I agree with Tyler's number one. That wasn't mine, but that is a genius idea to bring that show back, because that's one of my favorite comedies of all time. My number one is my favorite drama of all time, and it goes along with Tyler's number three that not a lot of people have heard this show. This is called Life. So are you aware of this show?
Loved Life.
Okay, so before Billions and Homeland, the actor known as Damian Lewis was on the NBC show that aired from 2008 to 2009. Again, only two seasons. It was cut short due to the writer's strike. So in this, he played a cop who went to prison, then had to come back and be a detective. But in this, he learned basically Buddha or basically a Zen kind of lifestyle, and he applied that to his detective work. And that show, I mean, it had a lot of philosophy. So you're talking like Bruce Lee, we talked about this earlier, the 30 for 30, that he had a lot of philosophy in his movies. This was a TV show that instilled the same things.
Yeah, like, man, two seasons I think we were lucky to get, because it was really good. It was really entertaining. It's no surprise that he's had success as the lead character in a couple other shows, because he's a captivating character. Yeah, and it was one of those shows that the trend of how it works catches on, so each episode focuses on one central story that has to be solved,
mm-hmm.
but then there's always the clues of the bigger story in the background.
And each one had a life lesson in it, too.
Yeah.
That's what I liked about that. Kind of like a, you know, kid show all about sharing or something like that.
But this adult life lessons.
Adult life lessons, yes.
Yeah, that's a great choice.
Life.
So, I mean, I almost think that we could go through, like, you know, and do another ranking of, like, one season shows that got canceled that you would have loved to have seen continue. So,
true.
Yeah, there's some good ones. Great choice.